When I was a boy, I would ask people, "Do you like the snow?" Most people dismissed me outright. Some even grew angry. Here in El Nath, where it snows year-round, we had always known cold and hunger. They were part of our identity. We lived our lives in a never-ending war against the pair, generation to generation. Some believe the snow was our punishment. Maybe it was. After all, mankind has been performing terrible deeds since the dawn of history. But me, I never saw the snow as a punishment. Call it stubborn optimism. To me, snow is... We were living in a time where the end of the world never seemed far off. Humans were always destroying things. And as for me, I couldn't claim to be any different. We fought for a king we'd never seen. As a child, I really thought the war would end someday. It was years before I saw the truth of the world. But what could I do? a flower, ill-suited for the frigid cold. What was her story? Who could say? This world never made much sense. stood spellbound. The Lion King was an idol to the men of Elnath, a beacon of courage. His castle stood sentinel atop that narrow peak, the symbol of a man without fear. And his castle was burning. War had returned. I said that I was looking for a tale, but that was just an excuse. A dormant instinct awoke in me. It told me that here, there was something to truly fear. I had to be sure. The once splendid halls were in ruins. Red-hot flames danced across the castle grounds. The fountains flowed not with meltwater, but boiling lava. What had they felt in their final moments? The Black Mage? I knew them at once. These were the perpetrators of all this destruction. Run! My instincts shouted. Yet my feet trudged forward, one step at a time, deeper into the castle. Swung my blade and desperately searched for answers. What had happened to this man, to this country? I had to run. Perhaps I could distract him. What powers might that witch possess? Could I break past her? As I weighed my options, the Lion King spoke.
It was I who destroyed the cities of El-Nath.
had a dream that I was walking in an endless snowfield. Those fallen in battle rose one by one in penance for my crimes. Poor fool, look upon the horrors you have wrought. What did you fight for? I asked. In the end, it's kill or be killed. What did you die for? I asked. One day this war will surely end. I asked, do you think we will be forgiven? The Lion King scoffed.
There is no forgiveness or redemption for people like us.
I was devastated. That horrible memory replayed itself before my eyes. That child from 5 years ago. I wonder what they look like now. Were they a casualty of this unending war? Or dead from cold and famine? Or perhaps they're out there wandering in the snow, once more a refugee. Just like thousands of other displaced children. When I awoke, I took up the sword I thought I would never again wield. And before long, I was running back toward the battle I had never wanted to fight. Dragon Master said. He had built a watchtower to warn the people when danger struck. Could he have prevented this? We'll never know. Alicia said, the Black Mage is the transcendent of light, but he yearns to become the transcendent of life. Transcendent, Dragon Master? These titles are foreign to me, as are their meanings. I never concerned myself with anything beyond the world in front of me. So I decided to focus on the journey ahead. We would travel to the Dragon Master's Tower. Please don't give up on us. She was suddenly quiet. In the following silence, there was no telling what she was thinking. Hopefully, she understands. Perhaps she sees that we are not beyond hope. We're just lost children trying to find our way. Every child needs a mother to watch over them and guide them. I couldn't recall the last time I cried. A single tear rolled down my icy cheek. It blew away on the wind, but its warmth lingered for some time. The melody vanished into the endless fields of snow. Perhaps this would be our last time together. I could not help but smile as I recalled our first meeting. We stayed this way for a long time.
As a transcendent and the mother of all life, I, Alicia, speak. You are forgiven of all your sins. So stop blaming yourself, Captain.
There was no hope of winning this battle. I was not blind. But I could not lower my blade. I owed the world far too much for that. When I realized I could no longer stand, no matter how hard I tried, I knew my end was not far off.
What's your name?
Ryud.
You fought well, Ryud.
So this is it. This is how my life ends. No one to witness. No one to remember. Vanishing beneath the falling snow. Brave heroes, it's all up to you now. I beg of you, don't let our deaths be in vain.
I'm here, Captain. It's been a while, huh? What do you think? Look how much he's grown. Now, where should I begin? Well, many people gathered at the site of the beacon you defended with your life. Among them were heroes powerful enough to go up against the Black Mage. Succeeded in sealing him away. Oh, I just said we, didn't I? Yes, I helped too. I had to use up all my strength to do it. Did you know that? But don't read anything into it. I'm just a mother. It's my duty to protect my children, right? And I'm afraid I have some sad news. Haze was found at the location of the blast. It seems he triggered the explosives manually. With all of the monsters around, I'm sure there was no other way. Myler was found next to the beacon. He exhausted all of his life force to speed up its activation. So, as your people would say, they've gone back home. You did well, Ryud. Now you can rest in peace, too. It's time to go back home. I'll take your sword. That's all right, isn't it? Now it's time for us to say goodbye. You stay here in this world. Ryud risked his life to save it. There's no need for the Ark now. I don't know when the world will next be in danger. But I am certain another hero will arise. Well, that's the end to the story of Ryud, a wandering hero. Even if no one remembers his name, I'm sure he'll be content with having saved many lives with his sacrifice. Goodbye, Ryud. Thank you.